the people that are destroying the planet, the worst offenders at destroying the planet, are non-whites.
The Daily Wire's Matt Walsh made those comments on Wednesday on his show. To try to parse what he's saying, you need a little bit more context, and we have that for you. This is Aisha Sadiqa, a climate advisor to the UN on who is driving climate change. Watch.
I say this because the climate crisis is not passive. The climate crisis is not a result of natural disasters, it's actually man-made. It's a result of...
I'll say it again, but I think they missed it.
The climate crisis is man-made. And it's not just man-made, it's white man-made. It is a result of capitalism, years of colonialism, years of racial oppression.
And now let's go to Matt's full response.
Well, most of the air and water pollution on Earth comes from Asia. In fact, we talked about it recently, that one Asian country has 83 of the top 100 polluting cities, like the cities that have the most pollution. One Asian country has 83 of those top 100 cities, and that's the country of India. That's Asia, and then Africa is the second worst offender when it comes to water pollution specifically, which means that the people that are destroying the planet, the worst offenders at destroying the planet, are non-white.
Now we've got more, we'll show you charts and graphs. We've got data showing what's true, what isn't true in that. But Cenk, I want to bring you in. What do you make of this argument that not only is climate change man-made, it's white man-made?
Pausing here to deliver some honest truth as we do in our news coverage as well. TYT is facing challenges, guys, as the entire industry is. You know who could make the difference? You. If you hit the join button below, it's going to make all the difference and keep us in business. We appreciate you, thank you.
Look, I don't think it's helpful, and I get it, I understand the great majority of the oil executives, will probably go through them in a sec, are white. Did white folks generally start industrial revolution? Yeah, they did, but we want to be united on this issue. The entire planet is in danger, not just minorities or white people, we're all in danger. So it doesn't help to insist that it's white man made. And will, is it true that in that people will add to climate change in places like India and China, and they're not white? Yeah, of course it's true, right? Being greedy, unfortunately, is a universal concept, right? And being short-sighted is a universal concept. But having said that, this woman is like, she theoretically, I guess she works at the UN, but it's not like she's a high-ranking official. She's very young, right? What the right wing does is they find a needle in a haystack. So there's overwhelming evidence that climate change is real, it's man-made, and we have to do something, otherwise we're all in very real danger, right? Agreed to by 99% of the world's climate scientists. But they find a rando at the UN who's giving a rando speech and make her seem like she is the leader of all libs and the leader of the Democratic Party and the climate change movement. And she said, white man, can you believe it? Right? Now, Jordan's gonna tell you in a little bit why they might be going in that direction. But first, Yasmin, what do you think?
Yeah, you know, there's a lot here, and ultimately it just needs so much more information and context. You know, we need those charts and graphs, Jordan, and I know you have them. But you know, the girl in the video, I'm sure she was very well intended. She didn't necessarily say anything so groundbreaking, but you have to back up certain things if and when you say them. But ultimately, I do agree with Cenk. I don't think that this is a productive way to address the climate crisis. There are so many millions of other things to discuss related to climate. Not just to climate, but also to the impacts it has on the global economy and to industry and to different countries and the way that they receive the climate crisis and what they do with it in turn, right? And we're gonna get into that in a little bit, I know. But it's just a very broad statement to make, and it doesn't mean anything. So let's find some more context, Jordan.
Yeah, it's one of those statements that will get a lot of plaudits in certain rooms and people will do it. Sometimes performatively, but let's stick to the facts here. Let's look at the argument that Matt Walsh is making that non-whites are destroying the planet. So here is a chart published in 2021 from The Guardian that illustrates how total carbon dioxide emissions in billions of tons from 1850 until now. You can see the US leads that despite his argument that it's Asian countries doing this. China is larger, but that is a recent development. And as you can see, the US clearly is leader by a wide margin. But if you really want to get nitpicky, and we are the fairest show in America. No, Matt Walsh did not make up the 83 cities statistic out of thin air. All but one of the 100 cities in the world's worst air pollution last year were in Asia. The vast majority of these cities, 83, were in India, and all exceeded the World Health Organization's air quality guidelines by more than 10 times, according to the report by IQ Air, which tracks air quality worldwide. But don't worry, because we're going to offer up another counterpoint. Take a look at the CEOs of the top five oil companies. Here's BP CEO Murray Auchincloss.
Looks Indian.
Chevron CEO Mike Wirth.
Chinese.
ExxonMobil CEO Darren W. Woods.
Black.
And ConocoPhillips CEO Ryan Lance.
That brother's white.
Yeah. You get the idea. But just for the record, Wael Sawan, the CEO of Shell, is Lebanese Canadian.
Oh, Lebanese Canadian. We got a little bit of diversity there.
Yeah.
Okay, for the people listening on the audio podcast, I'm kidding around. They were all as white as you could be until you got to Yoel. Okay. Yeah. But again, that doesn't prove anything, guys. It's just, we're just disproving what Matt Walsh said, because he took a little absurdity and made a mountain of absurdity on top of it. Like, white people, we would never do climate change. Yeah. Really, brother?
Yeah. But it's, what's important is not how Matt Walsh is wrong, but why he is saying it. We have context on that as well. The answer probably has something to do with the company he works for. The Daily Wire is funded by oil and gas billionaires.
Ding, 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 ding.
What do you know? In 2012, Dan and Ferris Wilkes had sold their fracking company, FracTech, for $3.5 billion and each pocketed $1.4 billion. They now intended to use their new fossil fuel fortune to shift the moral values of the entire country, and the right-wing influencers they enlisted for the cause went on to become some of the world's biggest purveyors of climate disinformation. In 2013, the brothers decided to donate more than $6.5 million to Prager University, which doesn't have a campus and isn't actually an accredited university. And in 2015, not long after the donation to PragerU, Ferris Wilkes provided $4.77 million in seed funding to start the Daily Wire. Wilkes remains one of the owners of the Daily Wire, which has amassed more than 27 million followers across its social media platforms, and in 2021 reported annual revenues of 100 million. Cenk, surprised?
Yeah, no, I knew that. But get a load of what Jordan's explaining. So Matt Walsh works at the Daily Wire. So their job is to make sure you don't do anything about climate change, because the people who own the Daily Wire are the ones claiming, creating climate change, right? So what do? They find a rando at the UN, and then they make it seem like she's a really important person. And the reason they do that is because they want to divide you based on race. And you just heard us criticizing her for dividing on race as well, right? But she doesn't have any power, and she doesn't, she's not at a $100 million company, etc. No, this company has made an active decision that they're going to find a way to divide us on race so that we don't work together to actually fight climate change and save all of us, right? Which, by the way, is right-wing media 101. Why do you think they always talk about the culture wars? Notice they almost never talk about economic issues. And I've said this 100 times, you'll see on cable news, the minute there's a culture war issue, they all fight. The minute there's an economic issue, all of a sudden all the anchors at Fox News, CNN, and MSNBC agree. And so here's the folks at the Daily Wire going, don't believe the stupid scientists. Of course they're not right. And by the way, part of all of that science and medicine denial at COVID is partly driven by right-wing media that doesn't want you to believe any scientists, because they're funded by these giant oil and gas companies who want to make sure that you never ever address that problem so they can make billions more. And if in the and one of their byproducts of their oil and gas drilling is obviously climate change, and by the way also pollution. But a third byproduct is the culture wars that we're in, because they had to create the culture wars to distract you from actually addressing the real problem here.
Yeah, and you have to wonder, why does this still work on people, right? Everybody knows to follow the money and to look at who's beholden to what, right? Like even people on the right, even like the very QAnon MAGA people know that little term, follow the money, right? They know that, but it's very rarely, or less often, I should say, actually put into practice. So whenever you have an issue like this, one that is cultivated, a cultivated issue, because this isn't a real problem. The real problem is the fact that we have issues with our climate now. However we got here, we need to understand how we got here, but we need to move forward from this point, right? But that's not what Matt Walsh is talking about here. He's trying to distract, he's trying to talk about something else entirely, because a culture war is really just a PR campaign that is spread out across, you know, across the country, maybe even across the globe, and it has millions of players around the world, right? And the people like Matt Walsh who are pushing forth these ideas and these culture wars and giving them life, they rely on those millions of people around the country and around the world to really embody them, right? To embody that fear of, you know, the white man is going to get blamed for all of this. And that's what they're afraid of. And that's not what they want. And so they'll get distracted with that. And then they're not even going to worry about the actual climate change. By the way, we're in for a really rough hurricane season on the Gulf Coast this year. So that's something to look forward to.
Yeah, but as long as people are fighting over race, they won't even notice that their house was destroyed by the climate change created by the oil and gas companies.
I'm actually afraid of the hurricanes, the actual hurricanes.
Because you know why? Because they're actually real. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.